Hello there. Welcome to Cosmos in a Nutshell. In today's video we will talk about Ganymede, the moon with magnetic field. Ganymede, a satellite of Jupiter, is the largest and most massive of the solar system's moons. The ninth largest object in the solar system, being the largest without a substantial atmosphere. It has a diameter of 5,268 kilometers, making it 26% larger than the planet Mercury by volume, although it is only 45% as massive. Chinese astronomical records report that in 365 BC, Ganda detected what might have been a moon of Jupiter, probably Ganymede, with the naked eye. However, Ganda reported the color of the companion as reddish, which is puzzling since the moons are too faint for their color to be perceived with the naked eye. Xi Shen and Ganda together made fairly accurate observations of the five major planets. On January 7, 1610, Galileo Galilei observed what he thought were three stars near Jupiter, including what turned out to be Ganymede, Callisto, and one body that turned out to be the combined light from Io and Europa. The next night he noticed that they had moved. On January 13, he saw all four at once for the first time, but had seen each of the moons before this date at least once. By January 15, Galileo came to the conclusion that the stars were actually bodies orbiting Jupiter. Galileo claimed the right to name the moons he discovered. He considered Cosmian stars and settled on Medicean stars. The French astronomer Nicolas Claude Fabre de Peresca suggested individual names from the Medici family for the moons, but his proposal was not taken up. Simon Marius, who had originally claimed to have found the Galilean satellites, tried to name the moons the Saturn of Jupiter, the Jupiter of Jupiter, this was Ganymede, the Venus of Jupiter, and the Mercury of Jupiter, another nomenclature that never caught on. From a suggestion by Johannes Kepler, Marius once again tried to name the moons after the mythological Ganymede, a Trojan prince desired by Zeus, the Greek counterpart of Jupiter, who carried him off to be the cupbearer of the gods. This name and those of the other Galilean satellites fell into disfavor for a considerable time, and were not in common use until the mid-20th century. In much of the earlier astronomical literature, Ganymede is referred to instead by its Roman numeral designation, Jupiter III, a system introduced by Galileo, in other words the third satellite of Jupiter. Following the discovery of moons of Saturn, a naming system based on that of Kepler and Marius was used for Jupiter's moons. Possessing a metallic core, it has the lowest moment of inertia factor of any solid body in the solar system and is the only moon known to have a magnetic field. The average density of Ganymede suggests a composition of about equal parts rocky material and mostly water ices. It is a fully differentiated body with an iron-rich, liquid core, and an underground ocean that may contain more water than all of Earth's oceans combined. The mass fraction of ices is between 46% and 50%. Some additional volatile ices such as ammonia may also be present. Its surface is composed of two main types of terrain, dark regions, saturated with impact craters and dated to 4 billion years ago, cover about a third of it, and lighter regions, cross-cut by extensive grooves and ridges and only slightly less ancient, cover the remainder. The cause of the light terrain's disrupted geology is not fully known, but was likely the result of tectonic activity due to tidal heating. Ganymede's magnetic field is probably created by convection within its liquid iron core. The meager magnetic field is buried within Jupiter's much larger magnetic field and would show only as a local perturbation of the field lines. Ganymede has a thin oxygen atmosphere. Atomic hydrogen is a minor atmospheric constituent. Whether Ganymede has an ionosphere associated with its atmosphere is unresolved. Ganymede orbits Jupiter at a distance of 1,070,400 kilometers, third among the Galilean satellites, and completes a revolution every 7 days and 3 hours. Like most known moons, Ganymede is tidally locked, with one side always facing toward the planet, hence its day is 7 days and 3 hours. Its orbit is very slightly eccentric and inclined to the Jovian equator, with the eccentricity and inclination changing quasi-periodically due to solar and planetary gravitational perturbations on a timescale of centuries. These orbital variations cause the axial tilt, the angle between rotational and orbital axes, to vary between 0 and 0.33 degrees. Ganymede participates in orbital resonances with Europa and Io. For every orbit of Ganymede, Europa orbits twice and Io orbits four times. Conjunctions, alignment on the same side of Jupiter, between Io and Europa occur when Io is at periapsis and Europa at apoapsis. Conjunctions between Europa and Ganymede occur when Europa is at periapsis. The longitudes of the Io-Europa and Europa-Ganymede conjunctions change with the same rate, making triple conjunctions impossible. Such a complicated resonance is called the Laplace resonance. The current Laplace resonance is unable to pump the orbital eccentricity of Ganymede to a higher value. The value of about 0.0013 is probably a remnant from a previous epoch, when such pumping was possible. The Ganymedean orbital eccentricity is somewhat puzzling. If it is not pumped now, it should have decayed long ago due to the tidal dissipation in the interior of Ganymede. This means that the last episode of the eccentricity excitation happened only several hundred million years ago. Because Ganymede's orbital eccentricity is relatively low, on average 0.0015, tidal heating is negligible now. However, in the past Ganymede may have passed through one or more Laplace-like resonances that were able to pump the orbital eccentricity to a value as high as 0.01 to 0.02. This probably caused a significant tidal heating of the interior of Ganymede. The formation of the groove terrain may be a result of one or more heating episodes. There are two hypotheses for the origin of the Laplace resonance among Io, Europa, and Ganymede: that it is primordial and has existed from the beginning of the solar system, or that it developed after the formation of the solar system. A possible sequence of events for the latter scenario is as follows: Io raised tides on Jupiter, causing Io's orbit to expand, due to conservation of momentum, until it encountered the 2-to-1 resonance with Europa. After that, the expansion continued, but some of the angular moment was transferred to Europa as the resonance caused its orbit to expand as well. The process continued until Europa encountered the 2-to-1 resonance with Ganymede. Eventually, the drift rates of conjunctions between all three moons were synchronized and locked in the Laplace resonance. Several probes flying by or orbiting Jupiter have explored Ganymede more closely, including 4 flybys in the 1970s, and multiple passes in the 1990s to 2000s. Pioneer 10 approached in 1973 and Pioneer 11 in 1974, and they returned information about the satellite. This included more specific determination on physical characteristics and resolving features to 400 kilometers on its surface. Pioneer 10's closest approach was 446,250 kilometers. Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 were next, passing by Ganymede in 1979. They refined its size, revealing it was larger than Saturn's moon Titan, which was previously thought to have been bigger. The groove terrain was also seen. In 1995, the Galileo spacecraft entered orbit around Jupiter, and between 1996 and 2000 made 6 close flybys to explore Ganymede. These flybys are denoted G1, G2, G7, G8, G28, and G29. During a G1 flyby in 1996, the Ganymedean magnetic field was discovered, while the discovery of the ocean was announced in 2001. Galileo transmitted a large number of spectral images and discovered several non-ice compounds on the surface of Ganymede. The most recent close observations of Ganymede were made by New Horizons, which recorded topographic and compositional mapping data of Europa and Ganymede during its flyby of Jupiter in 2007 en route to Pluto. On December 25, 2019, the Juno spacecraft flew by Ganymede during its 24th orbit of Jupiter, and got images of the moon's polar regions. The images were taken at a range of 97,680 to 109,439 kilometers. The Europa-Jupiter system mission had a proposed launch date in 2020, and was a joint NASA and ESA proposal for exploration of many of Jupiter's moons, including Ganymede. In February 2009, it was announced that ESA and NASA had given this mission priority ahead of the Titan-Saturn system mission. EJSM consisted of the NASA-led Jupiter-Europa orbiter, the ESA-led Jupiter-Ganymede orbiter, and possibly a JAXA-led Jupiter-magnetospheric orbiter. ESA's contribution faced funding competition from other ESA projects, but on May 2, 2012, the European part of the mission, renamed Jupiter Icy Moon Explorer, obtained a L1 launch slot in 2022 with an Ariane 5 in the ESA's Cosmic Vision Science program. The spacecraft will orbit Ganymede and conduct multiple flyby investigations of Callisto and Europa. The Russian Space Research Institute is currently evaluating the Ganymede lander mission, with emphasis on astrobiology. The Ganymede lander would be a partner mission for Jupiter Icy Moon Explorer. If selected, it would be launched in 2024, though the schedule might be revised and aligned with Jupiter Icy Moon Explorer. A Ganymede orbiter based on the Juno probe was proposed in 2010 for the Planetary Science Decadal Survey. Possible instruments include medium resolution camera, flux gate magnetometer, visible imaging spectrometer, laser altimeter, low and high energy plasma packages, ion and neutral mass spectrometer, UV imaging spectrometer, radio and plasma wave sensor, narrow angle camera, and a subsurface radar. Another canceled proposal to orbit Ganymede was the Jupiter Icy Moons orbiter. It was designed to use nuclear fission for power, ion engine propulsion, and would have studied Ganymede in greater detail than previously. However, the mission was canceled in 2005 because of budget cuts. Another old proposal was called the grandeur of Ganymede. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video and want to see more, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell so you don't miss anything. If you want to see a topic here, have any suggestions or want to make any corrections, don't be shy, the comment box exists for this. See you in the next video.